Mr. Janet Murguia, you are CEO of the National Council of La Raza. What's your opinion about the new Obama administration and the immigration reform?
Yeah, well, we're very excited to see President-elect Obama finally take the oath of office. What I can tell you is that he has been present in our community, has attended our events at the National Council of La Raza, and has committed to us that he is very interested in advancing our community and in looking at the issues that we care about, including jobs and education and health reform. And on immigration reform, he has committed to us that it is a priority for him, and we do expect to hold him accountable. So we're very encouraged by what we have heard from him on the issue of immigration, and we certainly are going to work very hard to champion immigration reform in this Congress.
When he was a candidate, Mr. Obama said that he was going to pass an immigration reform in the first year of his administration. Do you believe that's possible?
You know what? I think that they will move legislation in this year. I'm not sure it will pass this year, but I think that they will get a very good start on this bill so that we can see it passed early next year. I'm hopeful. We certainly want to work with you to make sure that's a reality.
With the Bush administration, there is an increase of incarcerations, deportations, families being separated. What has the National Council of La Raza done in order to protest this? Because a lot of Americans don't know this is happening, and it's a huge tragedy. Yeah. It's a human crisis.
Yes, well, it was the National Council of La Raza who first broke the report on the impact of the raids on our communities, and that was last year when we issued a report, also partnered with the Urban Institute, that showed how communities were being devastated by these families that were being separated, and how the result of these raids, which were targeting only employees and not the employers and not the owners, and how unfair it was and how costly it was to our society. So NCLR broke the report that really started the effort to question what the benefits of these raids were. We know that the laws have to be enforced, but there are costs to every action. And we have engaged the transition team with the Obama administration and encouraged them to review those raids and to stop those raids because we know how harmful they are. And we are hopeful once that President-elect Obama takes office, once he establishes his team, that we will see a realignment of those enforcement priorities and that we'll see those raids stop.
Are you aware of any involvement of the national governments of Latin America in this issue? Are they supporting their citizens in the United States?
I'm not aware of what other national governments are doing. I've only worked here within the United States to make sure that we're making the issues that affect our Latino community priorities for this new administration.
Finally, why do you think so-called Latino youth get involved into gangs or drop out from school? That's the statistics that the mainstream American media talks about. Is that true, and why is there?
Look, this a problem that we know is a crisis in our community, but also in our country. When we have dropout rates at the rate that they are, we have to have dramatic reform, and we need to see that reform in this new administration. President-elect Obama has talked about the need to see those reforms. We believe that we all have to play a part in that. We all have a role to play, and our Latino youth need to be reached out to and engaged. As parents, we need to be more involved in the day-to-day work, and as community-based organizations, we need to make sure those programs are offered, but we need leadership at the national level to make sure that we are reforming our education system so that every child has that opportunity to learn. And we're hopeful that with the policies that we've seen promoted by President-elect Obama, that we'll see some action. But our English language learners, NCLR has been at the forefront of advocating for funding to make sure that those English language learners can have the attention they need so they can enter mainstream classrooms ready to learn. And we've been supporting charter schools like Carlos Rosario, where we are today, so that folks can have access to job training skills and education. So we need to get more funding for those initiatives. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Can I ask you to choose one very last question? What's Latino? What is it? It's a race, it's a cultural identity. I personally identify myself as a Native American because I value my Native heritage. Do you think Latino is a race?
Well, I'm not sure. It's subject to everybody's interpretation. What I do know is that we're not a monolithic group. I mean, there are differences among us as a community. There are Mexican Americans, Puerto Ricans, Cuban Americans, Central Americans, and South Americans, all of us, and Spaniards. And what I, you know, everybody has to be comfortable identifying themselves the way they wish. I do know this, that there will be strength and in our unity if we can come together and advance those issues that we have in common. And if we can be unified as a community, then we will have more strength and ability to have the change and to advance our community and our country. Thank you.
Do you know your ancestry?
That's it. What's that?